name Saga Day.
Kids, they just love it. They just cannot get enough Faygo.
Way to go, Faygo.
All right, a new book dives into the evolution of Faygo and the
Faygo flavor.
The tasty drink with creamy head goodness.
Now's the time for you to go for Faygo Old Fashioned Root Beer. The big 1 liter bottle is now on sale at participating grocers.
And I found a Faygo item and I went to the Faygo plant.
Faygo, what a fun name for a soda. Such a fun name that a lot more people have heard of it than people who have actually tried it. With that notoriety comes a lot of questions. Questions I tried answering, but my answers wouldn't have been enough. I want you all to see for yourself. Making this video was kind of like watching a train wreck, except use both trains as a metaphor for my own life. Let me start from the beginning. Back in May, I had held a baking competition for my birthday. 8 of my closest friends and family competed and I judged and reviewed the videos, posting them on YouTube. I loved eating on camera so much that I began reviewing other things that I found. Things like pizza, things like chocolate, cookie, more pizza, the same pizza, toilet. The clamshell grew exponentially with every video I released. My subscriber count climbed higher than I ever thought possible. I felt a new kind of pressure, an unspoken oath to the clamshell to deliver hard-hitting reviews of the products you're all curious about. And so I landed on Faygo, beloved soda of the Insane Clown Posse, this American pop with a fantastic name. What is Faygo? Let's ask this roadie for ICP.
Faygo's the ghetto pop. If you take a look around, we're here in the ghetto here in Detroit, and we were all raised drinking cheap soda pop. We can't afford Pepsi and Coca-Cola like Michael Jackson, you know what I mean?
Alright, for those unfamiliar with the Insane Clown Posse, allow me to sing you a couple of their biggest hits. This isn't a like Insane Clown Posse diss, like making fun of them video, because I actually kind of have a lot of respect for them. They're super successful and independent, and like if you keep watching the video, there's lots of reasons to make fun of them, but there's lots of reasons to respect them a bit too. So I'm not making fun of juggalos at all either, because I terrify them. I remember those clown sightings in 2016. Don't want any part of that. Plus, there's so many of them, they crush the clamshell if any of us fucking said anything. I consulted local juggalos. They described Faygo like drinking clown tears mixed with hummingbird food. I had to have it. A local convenience store was rumored to have my sweet, tasty treat, so I set off in hot pursuit. They know me pretty well here, but I still have to use my spy cam. I don't want them knowing that I'm a YouTuber now. It cuts out here and I ask where the Faygo is. The cashier points over to the Faygo section. No 2 liters. This is disappointing to me. I've never even seen a can of Faygo in any of the videos I looked at. I don't know if it'll work. The only thing in between me and these cans is this fucking door. I don't know what I'm doing here. Pretty sure I was trying to push it to the side. Whatever.
How you doing? Three Faygos, please.
Anyways, I took the Faygo home, and I like to inspect the stuff before I review it. I mean, obviously, you want to see if there's anything interesting on the can or any interesting ingredients or whatever. I was expecting a bunch of clown stuff, but I didn't notice any ICP reference, so I went to their website to see what was up. There's red flags everywhere. Nothing to do with the Insane Clown Posse. I didn't fucking get it. I don't know what's going on right now. I checked the history. 1907. My eyes popped out of my head. I didn't believe it. I didn't know what this meant. Are the Insane Clown Posse 113 years old? Did they invent rap? Did they fucking invent, like, soda itself? Did they not invent Faygo? Like, I don't know. The clamshell had questions I didn't have answers to yet. Started in 1905, two brothers, Ben and Perry Fagenson, landed in Detroit alongside 17,000 other Russian immigrants. They were bakers, but competition was fierce. A fellow baker named Nathan Goldman had accused them of spreading handbills in Hebrew, saying that he was selling old, shitty bread. The drive to succeed led them to start bottling seltzer water, and they were soon producing pop with their own frosting recipes. Business boomed. Soon after, they purchased a truck. With the short shelf life of their pop, every second saved counted. In 1921, they changed their name from Fagenson to Faygo because it fit on the labels better. Faygo beating out other contemporaries such as Fagi, Fayga, Faygo, and my personal favorite, Fage. By 1922, they had over 8 different flavors, including lithiated lemon, sassafras root beer, and rockin' rye jazz drink, which sounds sexual to me. In 1935, they moved to 3579 Gratiot Ave, where they remain to this day. In the 40s, he passed on the company to their sons. He took it into the 50s and started broadcasting commercials during Detroit Tigers games, which really helped with exposure because some of these commercials are batshit crazy. Look at this one called the Faygo Kid. You see this guy get shot like 11 times for just like 10 bottles of Faygo. Look, he just blasts him. He's Swiss cheese. And then what, he dies? That's the same stagecoach driver from before. And then what's this guy? You don't know that's a jail. Well, there's a lock on it. I was thinking it might have been an insane asylum. Anyways, here's some more commercials. As you can see, some of these are just too good. I'm just going to let you bask in it for a little bit.
When you want something sinfully sweet with delicious natural taste, way to go, Diet Faygo. When you're crazy for something incredibly rich and you want over 20 flavors to choose from,
way to go, Diet Faygo.
Way to go.
Just a can of Faygo.
Oh, what flavor would you like?
Well, what flavors have you got?
Well, we have orange, root beer, grape, berry cherry cola, lemon lime, fruit punch, rock and rye, and red pop. We'll take the red top.
No, no, I want it.
Tut, tut, tut. I've got the money, so I'll make the choice. Will that be regular or sugar-free diet? We'll take the diet.
Regular.
Oh, my. Well, this is another fine mess you've gotten me into.
Good old Faygo Red Pop.
I think that was regular.
When was the last time you had a good slug?
Due to Faygo's advertising campaigns, they've created a whole generation of fans, including celebrities, such as comedian Bill Burr. Let's see what he has to say.
I've been drinking Faygo Red Pop since I was a kid. My friends know I love it. Now everyone's gonna know I love Red Pop.
What a fucking idiot. Look at him splash Faygo all over his head. Now we have Gary Coleman.
I've been drinking Faygo ever since I can't remember. I mean, my dad drank Faygo, grandfather drank Faygo. My favorite flavor is orange.
We got a little distracted, so let's get back on track. In the 60s, Faygo still had a problem of a short shelf life, and scientists couldn't figure out why. So they stopped pissing in the Faygo vats, and then it all suddenly was better. Just kidding, they started filtering the water, allowing them to have longer shelf life. They also invented the modern twist-off cap, which is actually a pretty big deal. Now, of course, they're over 100 years old. I guess they have fucking Faygo Day after them. It's kind of cool. Faygo Day. The next part of the video is going to be checking out the people currently working there. Let's see what Al Shudero's got to say.
Since 1907, we have been producing great tasting soft drinks.
Well, we're going to look at 100 years of Faygo memorabilia and some secret recipes.
And here's where we keep all our secret recipes. Come on, I'll give you a peek.
I'm holding the first ever Faygo bottle from 1907, and it was housed in this crate, which, as you can see on the crate, it showed that we had three phones. Big deal.
I started in December of 1969, and lo and behold, I'm still here 44 years later.
Now we have half-liter bottles. We have 24-ounce bottles. We have 2-liter bottles. We have 1-liter bottles. We have 12-ounce cans, 12-packs.
Went to the Faygo plant. I met Harvey Lipsky.
And my kids always called me the chief elixir mixer. So I said, that's pretty much what I did. I was the chief elixir mixer here. And Perry Ben Fagenson were the owners, and they ran the company. And Perry Fagenson was the flavorist. And he had a lot of distrust for chemists. So I was here 11 years before he showed me how to make the flavors.
Master high-low drivers carefully remove the giant pallets of pop from the end of the assembly line.
At this point, you're probably wondering, how did Faygo and the Insane Clown Posse get affiliated? And why do juggalos love it so much? Well, lucky for you and me, it wasn't very hard to find out.
And the whole ICP thing is with Faygo is they've been drinking it since they were kids and they really like it. And then just one time, all of a sudden, they just kind of took it and just threw it on the crowd and everybody kind of had a riot.
One day we were doing a concert in Detroit. We were doing synchronized dancing and he kept messing up the steps. So I grabbed a 2-liter Faygo and I busted him in the head with it. And everybody cheered and everybody loved it because it didn't make sense. So I turned around and he whacked me in the face with a 3-liter, and thus the war began. The crowd started throwing Faygo. Next day I looked, the club owner was swinging off the balcony with a 2-liter Faygo. My manager was jumping up and down on a 3-liter. Nobody knew what the hell was going on. It was pure pandemonium. And I'll tell you why people love it, because it doesn't make any sense.
Kids, they just love it. They just cannot get enough Faygo cola thrown on them.
If I was to go into your living room with 1 2-liter, shake it up and spray it on the walls, we'd have a problem. Imagine 300 of them.
But when the Faygo gets on your face, when you're wearing the makeup, it's not fun. But it's cool. I mean, it's, you get into it. It's pretty cool. It's crazy, yeah.
Come on! Jump the fuck up! ICP! ICP!
ICP! ICP! ICP!
The world famous Faygo box of flavor. Stuffed full of our favorite beverage. Holds about a 302 liters. Ton of pop. See, 69 cents because we have to buy so much of it, eh? Cheap. Faygo balloons for the uninitiated who like to hide in the back behind their girlfriend. This right here, super soaker. These should reach the balcony. Nobody's safe.
When we come out of the concert, soaking wet with Faygo, you're wet and it's 30 degrees, it's cold.
I love that, man.
And you get in your car and you're all wet and sticky. I mean, we never thought about it, but I'm sure you should take towels, but we never do for
sure. Yeah, we always forget.
Faygo loves us. We're like their best customer. They give us a great deal. Delivery's prompt. They send us Christmas cards, but they don't want to be associated with us in print or anything. They love our money, but they don't like us personally. So I'm used to it.
I'm working on a documentary in Chicago on a band called the Insane Clown Posse.
Mm-hmm.
Are you familiar with them?
Okay, I'm gonna tell you two things and only two things. The first one is we make Faygo for family consumption. And beyond that, I have no comment whatsoever.
They're getting rich and we're getting famous, so we're all happy.
So why aren't Faygo and the Insane Clown Posse officially affiliated? At first it was shocking to me, but it makes a lot of sense. Let's do a compare and contrast between a Faygo commercial and just a regular old Insane Clown Posse song.
Everybody ready?
Comic books and rubber bands climbing to the tree.
Yeah, okay, now let's hear that Insane Clown Posse song. This one's called I Want My Shit.
I wanna know voodoo! A fat bitch named Bridget!
And a little sip of Faygo too.
Till I get my shit in this motherfucker, I won't ever die!
So, there you have it. Not super family friendly. Plus, we also have this interview.
You know, we're not totally evil guys. Do you care about the audience?
I care very much about the audience.
All right. You said yesterday, you were greeting some fans, and you said to one kid,
how you doing?
You said, how old are you?
How old are you?
And the kid said, 12.
12? Did your nuts drop yet?
Did you drop your testicles yet?
Right.
To a 12-year-old.
Right.
How are you caring about this 12-year-old?
I'll tell you exactly how I'm caring about the 12-year-old. What 12-year-old in the United States, show me the neighborhood where a 12-year-old kid doesn't know what a pair of balls are yet. What neighborhood or what fantasy are we living in where you think your 12-year-old kids don't know what that is yet?
I know, but what good does it do that kid at 12 to hear you say that to him?
Because it really, I didn't hear nothing like that until I got older. And I knew about that since I was 8, you know what I mean? So it's just like a relief, like, yeah, you're treating me like, for real, it's real to the kid.
Also, you said, how old are you to another kid? He goes 14.
Good. I'm glad you're influenced by us. Do you need drugs? Go home and smoke something.
Go home and smoke something.
Now that right there, think about this. Come on now. This question right here. What I'm doing is I'm playing with them. You know what I'm saying?
There's also the fact that the FBI considers Juggalos and the Insane Clown Posse fans in general as a gang, I guess, in at least 4 different states. Which seems a little bit haywire to me. I mean, it's not like they made this fucking racist-ass commercial.
began. A long time ago, our tribe was hot and thirsty, and the great spirit Faygo appeared and said, "Here's a thirst-quenching, great-tasting soft drink just for you, and I call it Red Pop. You can share it with the early settlers when they come to America. It will give them something to give thanks for. And you, running pudgy, be thankful for Diet Faygo."
No, I am, Chief. I am.
I don't have any comment for that, other than I don't think that commercial would be made nowadays.
Okay, everybody, the time's finally come. I've been waiting for a week with these three Faygos. I wanted to finish all my research before I drank one so I could properly describe what I'm drinking. I got root beer, grape, and cherry. I couldn't find Red Pop. Red Pop's not the cherry pop. Cherry pop is something different. Yeah, I don't know. Watch the video up to this point. There's not much else to say. Let's give her a shot. Try the root beer. I don't know. Something's not right. Doesn't taste like anything. Doesn't even feel like there's liquid.
I knew right away that I was drinking it wrong. Of all the pops I had drank in my life, I had never experienced anything like this.
There's 33 grams of sugar in it.
I realized that in all the videos I had watched of people drinking Faygo and anything to do with Faygo, they all had 2 liters, or actually in a couple videos they just had a big bucket full of Faygo. But in that case I still needed larger denominations of Faygo, and I needed to figure out how exactly to drink it. I saw the videos of them spraying it everywhere, but I didn't quite know the technique. First step was finding the Faygo though, so I had to look up a good location. Dank Mart seemed to be the right kind of vibe for what I was looking for. Alright everybody, the moment you've been waiting for. I found it. I sourced it. I got Faygo. Hold on. Red Pop.
I'll take Red Pop. I'll have Red Pop.
I'll have the Red Pop.
Yeah, me. Red Pop. Big Faygo flavor. I love red. I love the flavor of red.
Does exist. This did not cost $1.29. I know it's American, but I don't think the conversion works out to fucking $5.50 Canadian. Well, I'm not blaming Dank Mart. I don't think they even distribute this shit around here, so they gotta sell it somehow, make money off it. Probably cost them $4.50 a bottle just to bring it in, so I'm just fucking pissed off. I got Faygo Red Pop, which I'm dying to try. And fucking Faygo root beer. Maybe I can actually taste it this time, we'll see. Now to figure out how to drink the Faygo. This whole video was actually pretty easy to do the research, mostly because I just stole other people's clips.
Here's the way it works. You open a 2 liter and you block it with your finger. You see what I'm saying? That's the whole secret to it. You hold it upside down and the fist starts to build. You see what I'm saying? The fizz really starts to build because you got it upside down. You're rapping. You're doing your thing.
It's hot and humid in the venue.
You know, and once you feel it ready to go.
You know, now that flop. On stage, it looks like you have a microphone in your hand as well. You have a microphone in your hand as well. You know what I'm saying? And then you would have a 2 liter or whatever. Now, tuck the 2 liter like this. Grab your, just your thumb and go.
Yep, see?
Man, shake that boy out.
There it goes.
Man.
Sorry, there goes some of it.
Awkward as a battle.
Yeah, that was.
Now, same premises, but usually like on stage, you'll have a pair of like batting gloves on, which will grip the actual 2 liter. So just one rip of the thumb sideways will make that boy pop
right
off.
And your finger's thicker with batting glove on, so it can cork the 2 liter better.
Right. So like you know, for purposes, just like that. Now, when you got it like this,
Either you drop it, and if you kick it outwards with the end of your foot, it's gonna sell. If you drop it straight down and you kick it with up here, it's gonna go straight up. Like, watch, I'll kick it with the top of my foot.
My car is gonna love that on the way home.
Oh! Oh! There it goes!
I was ready and I knew exactly what I had to do.
All right, everybody, we got the Faygo. We're here. I figured out how to drink it. I got my production crew here. We got Becky filming to my left. We got Bridget on the main camera. We got my buddy Arlen here. He's gonna spray me. Yeah, so if you saw the video, you know pretty much the only way to drink Faygo, I guess, is to have a fucking blast it in your mouth, like 100 fucking kilometers an hour. My production crew is already bitching about getting Faygo on themselves, so hopefully this works. We're gonna start off with a nice cherry cola. Shake it up real good. And pretty much gonna get my buddy to blast it at me. All right, let's go. That was actually pretty fucking good. Oh, I don't want to open my eyes facing the camera because all the Faygo and the face paint is going there. Cherry cola was really good. I'm giving that an 8.2. All right, next up is Faygo grape. This one has the most sugar in it, so I have high hopes. Oh, really? Fucking nose. That one's really good too. Oh, it tastes like grape, big league chew. Ground ball grape. Okay, I might have to do the rest of this blind.
We can give you a rinse here.
No.
No rinse.
Okay. Okay, we're doing Faygo, we're doing root beer. I already fucked it up. We're supposed to put our dip. Okay, we're just gonna have to fucking blast.
This is gonna be fun. One sec. Hold on.
You forgot it?
Oh.
No, barely any of that got in my mouth. Now I finally know what the root tastes like. It tastes okay. Oh, what did I give the grape? The grape was if the cherry was an 8.2, the grape was an 8.4. It was even better. The root beer I'm giving a 7.6. Now for my very,
last
not my very favorite, but for the one you've all been waiting for, we got Red Pop. And I'm gonna find out for sure what the fuck Red Pop is as a flavor. I know it's red. Ah! You gotta get some in my mouth. Not as big of a fan as the Red Pop. Oh, I'm gonna get the Red Pop. It tastes like your traditional red lollipop. So it is strawberry. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. It's not strawberry, but I'm giving that one a 7.5. Root beer was better. All right, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. I couldn't find Faygo Moon Mist. That's still a cool name. I'm hoping to do another video where I try it out in the future. I hope you like and subscribe. This fucking hurt my eyes balls a lot. So, oh, it's water. Please like and subscribe.